So my wife and I are at our friend's wedding. We just finished dinner and a tub of vanilla ice cream is opened up in the room next door. It's about 500 feet away. I have no idea this is happening. My wife, on the other hand, is completely overwhelmed by the smell of vanilla. In her words, it's assaulting her senses. And I also notice she hasn't touched her champagne. When she bolts to the ladies' room after feeling nauseous on the dance floor, it hits me. We're going to have a baby. We had a beautiful baby girl a few months later. But ever since that wedding, I wanted to find out more about why pregnant women get this superhuman sense of smell. And what causes those 2 a.m. pickle cravings? How does mom's diet influence the baby's favorite foods? On this Mother's Day edition of Reactions, we'll explain these and other amazing science facts about pregnancy.
Well, like many things in pregnancy, the changes that occur to a woman's senses really are largely related to hormones. During pregnancy, our levels of estrogen increase quite a bit, and as levels of estrogen change, we may note different aspects of our senses, and certainly smell and taste are big ones.
Probably 2/3 of pregnant women will report that they're very sensitive to odors. But when it comes to the science that tries to investigate this, there's not a lot of evidence for it. What may be changing is not what's the lowest concentration of an odor you can detect, but maybe the change in how much you like the odor, that what was once pleasant now is unpleasant.
There are a lot of hypotheses. Unfortunately, that's mostly what there are about how these cravings occur. Leptin is secreted by our fat cells. Leptin is known to decrease our appetite and increase our metabolism. We know that that leptin changes during pregnancy. Neuropeptide Y is another substance that's out there that's considered an appetite stimulant and has been shown to rise as pregnancy continues.
There is evidence that there may be heightened bitter taste sensitivity, especially during the first trimester. There's a whole host of hypotheses as why that may be the case, and actually that this heightened sensitivity may be protecting the fetus, because it's one of the results is mothers aren't eating bitter tasting foods that could contain toxins. It's just like they're learning about your voice, about the language you speak. They're also learning about the foods that you eat. It's a really beautiful and elegant system that is common to all mammals. Is that the first way in which we learn about foods are through these flavors that get transmitted from the diet via the bloodstream into the amniotic fluid and then to mother's milk. The baby has a well-developed sensory system that can detect these flavors. The baby will be learning, and there is research showing that if you eat these foods, your baby is in an advantage when you first offer those foods in liking them.
The whole like neural and hormonal interactions for mother-baby or parent-baby are really quite powerful. We know that oxytocin is a chemical messenger. It's released in the brain, and it's released in response to a social contact, particularly a skin-to-skin contact. What it then does is it incites desire for further contact. So it's part of the reason that we place the baby immediately on mommy's belly or up near her chest. We want that skin-to-skin contact to begin. High estrogen in pregnancy causes an increase throughout the pregnancy of the number of oxytocin receptors in mommy's brain. And then as oxytocin starts to surge in labor, so both baby and mommy are then exposed to that oxytocin, and it's literally would be like trying to set them up to start craving each other. In some ways, if you think too much about how all of these things work, very important for your doctor to be thinking about it. But as the person who's going through it, sometimes it's to try to recognize these are changes that happen, they're natural, they're important. They probably have a role, they're doing something good, but not to the point where we would become so obsessed and miss the miracle here, because really, indeed, it certainly is.